Hi, welcome to Power Electronics Lectures. In this video, I'll talk about introduction to power electronics. We'll go through the definition of power electronics. Why do we need power electronics? Where power electronics can make the difference? Then we'll go through the mode of conversion of power and take some simple examples. So let's start with the question, what is power electronics? Power electronics can be defined as a hybrid technology that involves the disciplines of power and electronics. So we can define the power electronics as a hybrid technology that involves two disciplines, the power and the electronics, mainly. Okay? Some researchers define it as a branch of engineering that combines the generation, transmission, and distribution through electronics means. So here we can say power electronics is a branch of engineering that involves the generation, transmission, and distribution. But we do this, the traditional things, the traditional power system, using the electronics devices. Others also define power electronics as a combination of electrical engineering, electronics, and control theory. But in my opinion, this still does not give a clear definition for power electronics as a standalone field. When we go and read in books and research journals, you will find that power electronics nowadays is a well-established field of engineering. And if you want to specialize in this field, you need to study it in depth as a standalone discipline. In conclusion, I prefer to give this definition for power electronics. We can say that power electronics is a field that studies in depth the integration of the new and the emerging energy resources to the traditional power systems by means of switching devices. And here we have two main things. We need to focus on two things. Number one is the new energy resources, and that includes photovoltaic systems, wind turbines, batteries, electric vehicles, and many other applications. We can include here any energy resources that do not belong to the traditional power system. The second important thing here is the switching devices. I clearly say that switching devices, not electronics or semiconductor devices, because there are many electronics under the umbrella of electronics, other than the power electronics devices. But when we define switching devices, then this clearly specifies the power electronics. So why do we need power electronics? Power electronics is important because we need to convert and integrate the power in a controlled manner. And that happens using switching devices. So we can draw switching device here. We can say that this is the IGBT. We can use the IGBT as a switching device, or we can use MOSFET, for example. Or we can say that this switching device is a diode, is a power diode, or silicon carbide, or any other type of switches. It can be a thyristor. There are many switching devices that can be used. It's very important to know that the power rating for these switching devices can be ranged from a few watts to several gigawatts. So the range of power for these devices can be from a few watts similar to what we see in the power banks and mobile chargers to several gigawatts. And that's what we see in the high voltage DC systems and fax devices and transmission lines and etc. Also, it's very important to know that the power electronics is different than or different from signal electronics, where in signal electronics we deal with small values of power that can be ranged from few nanowatts to a few watts only. So where power electronics makes the difference in power conversion system? Actually, the main advantage of power electronics is that when we operate the power in a switching mode, this makes a high efficiency conversion for the power conversion system. The efficiency of power electronics devices may approach as high as 98% to 99%, and that is a very high efficiency. So the efficiency of the power electronics components or the power electronics converters can reach up to 98% or 99%. And when we talk about a high power system or high power, the small fractions makes a huge difference. So switching devices make important arrangement here. You can imagine that energy is a big piece of anything. Let's say that this rectangle, for example, is the energy. Okay, switching devices can cut this energy piece into smaller pieces and store this energy inside the passive components. And these passive components usually are the inductors and capacitors in the power electronics system, and then we store these smaller pieces inside the capacitors and inductors. Then we can use these small pieces whenever we want without losing almost any of the energy during this process. In the traditional power system, we use to cut this energy piece and lose almost half the energy in order to convert it from one shape to another. But now we can keep it and use it in a very efficient way. The mode of conversion of power can easily be categorized to four main categories. The first one is the AC to DC converters. And these are the rectifiers. And the rectifiers usually can be divided into three main categories. Number one is the uncontrolled rectifiers, or what we call the diode rectifiers. The second part is the controlled rectifiers. And the third one is the half-controlled rectifiers. The controlled rectifiers are the thyristor circuit, and the half-controlled rectifiers can combine the diode rectifiers plus the thyristor circuit. The second part of these categories is the DC to AC converters, and these are the inverters, what we call inverters. Inverters cover wide range of circuits. You'll find the normal traditional two-level inverters here. Also, you can find the multi-level inverters. Within these two levels and the multi-level inverters, you'll find the single-phase inverters, the three-phase inverters, and many types of inverters. So inverters covers wide range of power converters. The third part here is the AC to AC converters. And these AC to AC converters can be at different frequency. And different amplitude. Or they can be at the same frequency but different amplitude. So here you can same frequency. So the input of the converter can be the input and the output of this converter can have different frequencies or can have similar frequencies, different amplitudes. Or they can have both different frequency and different amplitudes. Okay, the fourth part of the power converters are the DC to DC converters. So the DC to DC converters can be the traditional DC to DC converters, the simple converters, the non-isolated DC-DC converters, can be the switch mode power supplies, the isolated converters, usually you call the switch mode power supplies, or they can be the solid state transformers. This is the case for converting the power from one form to another, and that's what we generally call it a single stage power conversion. I should exclude the SSTs from here, as the solid state transformers use multi conversion stages. Sometimes the system requires multi conversion, so we have to convert the power from one stage to another. Like we should have the AC to DC and then from DC to AC. So here we have two stages. The first stage from AC to DC and the second one from DC to AC. And also it can be from DC to AC and then from AC to DC in one converter, similar to what we have in the solid state transformers or what we call the DC transformers. Let's have some examples. To widen our overview on power electronics conversion system, let's say that we have a battery that we need to charge from an AC source. So let's say that we have a battery here. Okay, we know that the battery is a DC power source, and if we want to charge this battery, we need also a DC power source. We need to charge this battery from an AC power source. So here we have an AC power source. So what type of converters we need in this case? We have AC here, and here we have DC. So definitely, if we think simply, we need a rectifier, AC to DC converter. Also, we can add a controller for the charging current to keep it at a certain value. Okay, so we can take feedback from here. Feedback for the current. Give it to a controller. Then, according to this value that's coming back from the battery, we can give more information to the power converter in order to supply, let's say, a constant current or the specified current that we need. Let's say that the battery is the power source and we need to control the speed of an induction motor. So what do we need in this case? If we have the battery as a source and we need to use this battery to control the speed of an induction machine. Okay, so definitely we need an inverter in this case, DC to AC converter. Let's say we have a power source with a 50 Hertz AC, okay? Here we have a power source, 50 Hertz AC, okay? And we need to control the speed of an induction machine . So this induction machine, we need to control the speed for this machine, okay? So of course here we need an AC controller, AC to AC at different frequency. The input of this converter is a 50 Hertz AC, and the output, for example, can be a 100 Hertz. So we can change the speed of this machine to 3000 RPM, for example, instead of 1500 if you want to use 50 Hertz. Okay, for example, if you want to generate a regulated DC supply from a battery, in order to control a DC motor speed, okay, here we have a DC motor, and we know that the DC motor, similar to what we see in the toys, this is a DC motor, so definitely it needs a DC power supply. So to generate a regulated DC supply from a battery, we need a DC to DC converter. Next video, I'll talk about why power electronics is very important. We'll shed the light on some applications and we'll give a brief history for power electronics components. So see you next time.